Hello everyone. In the series of Learning Database Management System, our today's topic is normalization. So prerequisite for this particular topic is redundancy, functional dependency, and how to find out closure of the proper of a attribute. All these are the prerequisite for normalization. So before going through this lecture, I request you to follow the previous lectures so you can understand better. Now, why we need normalization? In the earlier video, I have discussed about data redundancy. Now, what is a data redundancy? It is a condition that occurs within a database in which same data is present in multiple places. So, if we are having data, same data, on multiple places, then that problem is known as data redundancy. And ultimately, data redundancy will lead us to data anomalies. Anomalies are the problem that can occur in poorly planned or unnormalized database, where all the data is stored in one table. So we studied three types of anomalies: insertion anomaly, updation anomaly, and deletion anomaly. So basically, this normalization is a way, it is a process of organizing the data in database to avoid redundancy, to avoid insertion anomaly, update anomaly, and deletion anomaly. So all the problems which are happening due to redundancy and anomalies, normalization is a process to remove all those. So, if a table has data redundancy and it's not properly normalized, then it is difficult to handle and update the database without facing the data loss. If the data, if the table is not normalized, surely we will have data loss. And it will also take extra memory space. So, all these problems will be removed by normalizing. So normalization is a process where we will minimize the data redundancy and we try to remove all these anomalies problem. Okay, so there are various level of normalization. If you can see here, there can be first normal form, second normal form, third normal form, BCNF, Boyce code normal form, then fourth NF and fifth NF. So one by one, we are going to study each and every normal form. So let's start with first normal form. So first normal form, here are few rules. So if a table will follow these rules, we will say that the table is in first normal form or 1NF. Now, one important point for you students, if a table is not in first normal form also, then it will be considered as a bad database design. So minimum requirement for any table is to that it should be in at least first normal form, right? So first normal form follows the following rules. Now please see the rules. First rule is, a relation is in first NF if it contains an atomic value. Atomic value means for each and every row or tuple, there is only unique and atomic value is allowed. Fine. Next is, value stored in a column should be the same, should be of the same domain. Now, column domain or column type should be same. It should not be like the value for first few column is integer type and few column is of character type. It is not allowed. All the attributes in a table should have unique names. This is another important point that 1NF follows. So these are the three rules which every table should follow. And if it is following the following rules, it will be in 1NF. Okay. So let's see with the example. Here is a hospital database where we are recording the patient records. So if you can see here, we are having patient ID, patient name, address and mobile number. Let's see one by one each point. A relation is in first NF if it contains an atomic value. Now for each tuple, there should be an atomic value. So there is one atomic patient ID. Patient name is Raghu, only one name for this record. Address is Mumbai, no problem. But here if you can see, for this particular mobile number, for this attribute, we are not having atomic value, we are having two values. And it is quite possible in real life that a person can hold two number. But when we are creating a database according to the 1NF table, it don't allow non-atomic value. It should have atomic value. So what we have to do, we have to decompose this table. We have to bring it to 1NF. Fine. So what I can do, if I will unset this nesting, my work will be done. Can I decompose this table like this? Can I write it like this? That here I am having patient ID. Then I am having patient name. And here I am having patient address and mobile number. So here I am writing patient ID, patient name, then I am having patient address, and then patient's mobile number. Now, what we have to do? We have to unset the nesting. These values are not atomic. We have to make it atomic. So what I can do, for patient 101, I will create two tuples. Fine. So here it is Raghu, Mumbai. Now, these values are not atomic. Let's make them atomic. So here I am writing the first number and here I am writing the second number. Now it is atomic. So this first condition satisfy, a relation is in first NF if it contains atomic value. Here is a tuple with atomic value, here is a tuple with atomic value. Let's check another tuple. Because of this, there is no problem. 102 Ram lives in Bangalore, has only one mobile number. So no problem because of second tuple. So I can write P102 Ram Bangalore and only one mobile number this person has. So that mobile number. Now check for P103 any problem? So P103 is also a person with non-atomic value in mobile number. So what we have to do? We have to unnest the relation. So here P103 will come like this. Person name is Ranvijay. He is from Delhi. And two mobile numbers, we will make it atomic. Last person, Nikhil, because of him, no problem, already atomic value. So P104. So now the first thing, first rule is satisfied. Value stored is in 1NF a relation is in 1NF if the value stored is atomic. Fine. Now if you can see, all the tuples have atomic value. Let's check for another rule. Values stored in a column should be of same domain. Now my table is modified from here to here. So in this I will check. Value stored in a column should be of same domain, means type should be same. So if you can see, patient ID, it's of varchar type, it's containing integer as well as a character. Now all the values are of same type, no problem. P name, if you can see, all the name are of string type, no problem. P address, all the values are of string type, no problem, it's of same domain. Mobile number, all the numbers are integer, all are numbers, so no problem. right? So second rule also satisfy. So two rules of worst NF, one NF is satisfying. All the attributes in a table should have a unique name. All the attributes means what? All the column names should have unique name. They should not have same names, right? So check the table. Here the attribute name is patient ID. Here it is patient name. Here it is patient address and another is patient mobile number. So all the attributes in a table have unique name. Fine. So all three rules satisfy. So can I say now that this table is in 1NF, right? All these three rules should be satisfied. Then only we will tell that my table is in 1NF. Okay. Let's see another table. Now, have you noticed here in this question, we are not having any primary key. Fine. And the condition for primary key, I already discussed in the video lecture series where I discussed about keys. Condition for primary key is it should not be null and it should be unique. Now, if you can see here, if patient ID I will make as primary key, then because of this, it will not be unique, right? So this modification we are allowed to do because there is no primary key in my table. What if my table has a primary key now? So there are few steps which we have to follow for converting a table to 1NF. So here what we are doing, we are removing nested relation attribute in a new relation. Whenever we are getting nesting, we are removing it. We are making it as atomic, right? If there is a primary key, propagate the primary key into it. Fine. Next is unnest relation into a set of 1NF relation. Now, what these rules are saying, first understand this example so you can relate better. Here, if you can see, I am having a employee project details table. Now, here if you can see, the EMP ID, employee ID is a primary key. Right, then employee name, project number and working hours are there. Now according to the rules of 1NF, if you can see, a relation is in 1NF if it contains the atomic value. Now check whether we have atomic value here. EMP ID is atomic, name is atomic, project number are not atomic. Here two values are present for project number for a single person, for a single tuple. Similarly, working hours are not atomic. For this person, Archit is working in project 1 for 32 hours and project 2 for 8 hours. And it is coming under the same tuple. Fine. So this is violating the condition of 1NF. Fine. So what we have to do, we have to bring it to 1NF. Right. Now, check the rules. What it is saying. The problem is, why I cannot unset it like I have done in the previous example. Here also mobile number was creating problem and I just unset it. I just wrote P101 twice and I have given a unique value, atomic value to mobile number. Why I cannot do this thing here? Because as you can see, this employee ID is primary key. And rule for primary key is it cannot be null and it cannot be duplicated, right? If I will repeat E101 twice because of two project number and two working hours, my table will not allow me to do this, right? So what I have to do, I have to remove the nested relation. I have to remove this nested relation. Fine. And what I have to do, I have to propagate the primary key between two tables. And then I will unnest the relation into 1NF. So if this employee project detail table, I will divide into two table. That is, I will decompose it into two table. One is employee detail table. And another is project detail table. Then I think my work will be done. Because here there is a primary key and I just cannot unnest it simply. So what will happen in employee detail, first table, this employee project detail, I am decomposing into two table. One is employee detail. So in employee detail table, I will have only two attributes, that is employee details. So here I will create a table, that is employee detail table. with only two attributes. And what is the attribute name? One is employee ID, so EMP ID, which is a primary key, and we denote primary key by underlying the attribute name. So we are underlying employee ID, and another is employee name. So I'm writing here employee name. Okay, now I can write the employee. E101 Archit. E102 Anjum. E103 Yusuf. And E104, that is Shankar. Fine. So what I have done, I have divided, I have unnested this project number and working hour. I divided, I decomposed this entire table into two table, employee detail and project detail. So employee detail is done. Okay, another table, what I want to, I want project details. So here, now second point, if you can see here, remove the unnested relationship. We are removing the unnested relation attribute and we are creating a new relation. Propagate the primary key. Now what is the meaning of propagation of primary key? There should be some connection between these two tables. Otherwise, else I, when I want to join them, I will not be allowed to join them. How I will join if there is no common attribute? And the common thing we does with the help of the primary key. Fine. Now here what happened, there are two project numbers and there are two working hours for this employee 101. So only employee ID will not help me. What I have to do, I have to propagate the primary key and I have to make a combination of primary key here. So if I will take employee ID and project number as primary key, what I'm doing, I'm taking both as a combination of primary key. So now for employee 1, here we will have working hours. So no further divide is essential, only working hour. So for E101 and for project 1, how many hours he is working? 32 hours he is working. Again, EC101 and for second one, for second project, how many hours he is working? 8 hours he is working. So now EMP ID 101 is coming twice and it is allowed because it is having a combination of P number. So until and unless both numbers are not same, we can allow to write it like this. Fine. There is no duplicacy because this primary key is consist of EMP ID and P number. So E101 and 1 together makes it as a primary key. E101 and 2 together makes it as a primary key. Now the value for these two columns are atomic also, right? For E102, already there was no problem. She is only working in one project, project number 3, and all 40 hours she is dedicating to project number 3. Now for E103, if you can see, he is also working in two projects, 20 hours for one project and 20 hours for another project. So what I have to do, E103 is working in first project for 20 hours and similarly E103 is working on second project for 20 hours. Okay, now for this, he is a person, he is dividing his time 10 hours in 4 projects. So what we have to do, we have to create 4 tuples for him. Every value should be atomic, remember. So he is dividing his work. E104 is working in project number 2 for 10 hours. E104 is working in project number 3 for 10 hours. E104 is working in project number 6 for 10 hours. And E104 is working in project number 8 for 10 hours. So here it goes like this. So what we have done, we have divided the table employee project details into two tables, employee detail and project detail. So the nested relation, nested attribute, as it is saying, remove the nested relation attribute, that we have removed into a new relation. Fine. We have to propagate a primary key into it, otherwise we will not be allowed to connect to table. So here this employee ID and project number together we will work as a primary key. For this table, employee ID will work as a primary key, and this table will take its reference from this table. So employee ID will work as foreign key as well. Fine. So whenever I want to combine these two tables, I can be able to do that with respect to employee ID. Fine. Now, next what we have to do, we have to check this rules. First rule is satisfied. A relation is in 1NF if it contains an atomic value. Here if you can see, both the table, employee detail and project detail, have atomic value. There is no repetition, right? After that, you have to check what? Value stored in a column should be of same domain. Now let's check the domain, please. So if you can see, employee ID, it's a varchar type, alphabet is also there, and integer number is also there. Ename is of string type, same domain. Here you check, employee ID is a varchar type. P number, project number, is of number type. All are having same type, same domain. Working hour is also number type, no problem. Fine. So second rule also satisfy. Third rule says all the attribute in a table should have a unique name. Let's check the attribute name. Here attribute name is employee ID. Here it's employee name, unique name. Employee ID for this table, P number, project number for this, and working hour for this. So here also it is having a unique name, right? So like this you can propagate your table, you can divide your table, and you can bring it to 1NF if your table is not in 1NF. Fine. So here are few rules. These three rules you have to by heart, and you have to remember this, that a table will be in 1NF if these three rules are satisfied. If these three rules the table is not satisfying, you have to bring it to 1NF, and when these three rules will be satisfying, you can say your table is in 1NF. Fine. This is it for today. Thank you very much.